The year was 1967, the date August 12th. No one then realized that this day would signify the end of the world as they knew it, that ever after, nothing would be the same. A simple drive, the last time she'd drive in this world, in this car, in this frame of mind. Then she saw a strange man in the road. She couldn't take her eyes off him. His skin was so pale. His eyes ghastly. Before she knew it, he stepped into her path. There was no more time to think. He was there, and then there was nothingness. When Ruby woke up, she did not know how long she had been unconscious. She guessed a few hours. In actuality, it had been far longer. It did not seem like any hospital she'd ever been to. She did not know that hospitals no longer existed, and that someone brought her here out of charity. Looking around the room, she saw that her suitcase was there with her clothes still in it. She'd go find someone, some nurse or doctor, and go home. As she walked down the staircase, the silence was so profound that she felt she must be the only one there. She stepped out into the world. She was now in a wreck of a town. The town hall was in ruins. The library had burnt down. But most importantly, all the people were gone. It was as if she was the last person on Earth. Ruby stepped into the building where she once worked. The utter destruction seemed as if it had happened a long time ago. There was no furniture, no signs of life, nothing. After leaving the building, she entered what used to be the town park, which had now been reclaimed by nature. She was hungry and exhausted, and decided to rest for a moment. Suddenly, an arm grabbed her. She screamed and turned to see another woman who told her they needed to get off the road immediately. They sat in the bushes, waiting and watching. She fought the urge to ask questions, even when the strange couple appeared. She was fascinated and revolted. When she felt it was safe, her savior introduced herself as Mary Jane, a fellow survivor who was seeking out a safe haven. Mary Jane told her that there had been an outbreak of a disease, the ferocity of which had never been seen before. It spread so rapidly that within days almost everyone was affected. Governments collapsed into anarchy. Mass looting devolved into arson, murder, and destruction. Those who had not died immediately from the plague existed in a shadow state which resembled neither life nor death. Those who somehow escaped the disease now hid. Mary Jane said she had heard on the radio before the broadcasts ended that there was a place where the unaffected were living, where there was an entire armed militia. Eventually, after many hours of walking, they find a place to rest. One last thing, Mary Jane told her. You need to learn to defend yourself. Ruby protested that she could never use it. Mary Jane told her that she might not have a choice. Her eyelids heavy, Ruby leaned her head back to rest. Mary Jane told her to go ahead. She'd stay awake, and then they could switch. As Ruby began to drift off, Mary Jane warned her that one of them should always be keeping watch. Ruby nodded and fell asleep. It seemed like only moments had passed when she felt Mary Jane shaking her awake. She looked up at the stars, grateful that they still shone, and for a moment, felt at peace. She thought she would close her eyes for just a moment. She dreamed of her accident and the strange man who stood in front of her car. But in this version, she heard screaming. Was it her voice? She opened her eyes to see two feral yellow eyes staring back at her. There was no time to think. Ruby grabbed a rock nearby, raised it up, and smashed it down as hard as she could on the monster's head. She turned and saw Mary Jane, who was holding her neck. Ruby gasped, realizing that she'd been bitten. Her immediate thought was to find a bandage, but Mary Jane stopped her. She told her that it was too late for her, that Ruby must use the gun to kill her before she turned into one of them. You must use this to save us both. Ruby hesitated, unsure of what to do. She held the gun for what seemed like an eternity, and at last made her decision. Then she grabbed the pack and left. She remembered the map and continued to follow the route. After walking for a long distance, she began to worry that she had made a wrong turn. But then she heard it. Faint music in the distance. Her heart raced and she ran forward. This was it. She was safe. For the time being.